Greetings and welcome back once again to From the Depths, where in the previous episode we managed to fend off an attack from the Deepwater Guard, who are almost certainly going to be spending more things at us. So we really need to improve on the defenses of our fortress, because it was a fairly close battle, I don't mind admitting. However, we now have crystal resources at our disposal, and that means AI. I think, yes, the very first thing we're going to do in this, we're going to build up our bridge section. So let's go to blocks. Let's go to metal blocks, metal beams. We really need to make this area particularly difficult for the enemy to destroy. So, well, unfortunately, this isn't completely the same shape. So I'm going to have to do this little by little. There we are, and on there, and finally this there as well. Okay, that actually worked out. So we're going to build up this wall as we can. No, I'm not going to do that. In fact, I'm not even going to do this. Let me get rid of that and this. Okay, and there we go. We'll have a little room for window. Yes, I know. This is the bridge. We're not really meant to be making it all swanky, but still, I feel that not having a window, it's not good. We need natural light, otherwise my robot will get depressed. And you don't want a depressed robot. No, no, no. Just look at Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy on why you don't want one. There we are. Right, let's build that up there. Get rid of that. Okay, we've got the beginnings of our command area. Right, let's go back to the metal beams, just to reduce the required resources to render all of this, if we can. And bring that back. That should now fit. Fantastic. Get rid of this as well. And this as well. Okay, there we go. We are actually starting to cook with fire, as the saying goes. Let's bring this all the way down here, if we can. Yes, we can. And, okay, it actually worked out much better than I was expecting. Right, we'll fill this in up here. This gives us a bit of a command area. Now, I'm not sure how long we're going to have before the enemy forces arrive, and that is a little bit of a concern, because they are still sending level 30 troops at us, or rather fleets of strength 30. So this fortress is going to need to have a reasonable upgrade. As I said, the last attack, we kind of lucked our way out of losing that one, in my opinion. So yeah, we definitely need a lot more defenses. So let's work on that, shall we? Let's get this there and a little bit more metal blocks there. I'll worry about all of this. Well, I'll just do this bit, and then I'll focus on actually improving our defenses somewhat in a more interesting way. Okay. Now, we have got crystal. That means one very important thing. That means AI. We are going to build an AI. AI mainframes are the core of every AI system. These always point forwards in the ship, and we're going to situate this about here. That'll do. Right, we also want card slots left and right so that we can affix AI cards. And the AI cards program the AI in how to operate. In fact, looking at that beam there, let's get rid of that. We'll put an AI connector there instead. Will this actually allow me to? That's the question. Can I do this? Card slot front back. No, left right. Then AI six-way controller. And then another card slot, would it allow me to? Because if it does, then this is pretty good. Yes, okay, that's brilliant. Now, what I'm going to do here... Oh, damn it, I put it in the wrong place. Balls. Okay, well, I'll put it there then. I want this to go up and replace that beam so that I can hardwire in the weapon on top. But first, card target prioritization. This is one of the AI cards, and these go into the AI slots. This card can be inserted into a card slot and will allow prioritization of certain targets as both the primary target of the AI mainframe and the weapon systems. We want that. We want the AI to be able to pick important targets to kill. Next, aim point selection. This will select vulnerable points on the constructible for targeting. That is very good. It'll make our dwindling ammo supplies more efficient. Tracker target association. The card can be inserted into a card slot and will allow a clever assignment of targets to the tracker. Targets with the highest priority go first and are given only to trackers that can see them. We'll place that as well. Now, you can have more than one tracker on the on any constructible, and that will just allow you to have multiple weapons targeting different targets. Fortress AI. This will allow the fortress to move into position and gather resources and card patrol. There are only 5 cards currently. I imagine more will be added with time. Now then, what we want to do up here is another 6-way controller. But we want this to come out about that far. I want this to be directly underneath my weapon. There we go. It is underneath my weapon. Now, the reason why I want that is the local weapon controller. This controller will fire weapons and turrets connected to any of its 6 direction sides with a range of 2 blocks. That is 12 blocks, a check for weapons. As long as targets have been detected and or tracked by the associated mainframe, to control the rotation of a turret as well as the weapons of the size, place this on the main vehicle next to the turret or below. Connected to weapons forwards, back, up, down, left, right. Connection ranges 2 blocks. No diagonal blocks are connected to. Control cannons, missiles, and turrets. Control all cannons and missiles on a turret. Mainframe needs to be detected. Let's place this here and see if this detects the mainframe. Has no failsafe. Controlling 1 weapon. No mainframe connection. Ooh, that is not good. Very not good. Really? No mainframe connection? Okay. Alright, we have built this in a bad way. Okay, let's move things around just as well that we check this first. Alright then. Let's get rid of you and you. No, get rid of you as well. And finally you. Right, we want the mainframe here then. There we go. This should now be detecting the mainframe, I imagine. Yes, it does, and it's controlling 1 weapon. All right, then. We want front, left and right. There, and also there. And we'll place all the cards back in the slots. Aim point and target priority, tracker association, fortress AI, and patrol AI. Okay, that is our new AI mainframe. However, we want one final thing on the AI itself, and that is a wireless transmitter. This will allow it to connect to things that aren't literally hardwired into the system. Where are we going to place this? I would say probably worth placing it about here. There we go. Connected to mainframe, transmitting on channel 1. That is good. Finally, failsafe. This component can be attached to any local weapon controller and will make sure that the best of its ability that the weapon has a clear line of fire to the target before firing. That is of incredible importance. Let's place it there. That basically means that this cannon will not try to shoot our ship in order to shoot an enemy. Right. I am doing this fast just so that I can make sure we don't get utterly destroyed. Let's have a quick look. Where are our enemies? Oh, here we are. Wow, they're moving from far away. Okay, I was expecting to get attacked pretty soon, but we've got a little bit of time. Okay, let's take things down a notch then. Right, we want to interact with this. The maximum range to minimum range for a target doesn't matter. It can shoot anything, no matter how close. As long as it doesn't try to shoot our ship, and that's the failsafe, we'll take care of that. Maximum range to engage. Now, I happen to know that the maximum range you can detect something is about 600, or at least track it, but... Let's put this about... Tracking information just makes things a little bit easier for us. Let's put this about 750. I'm not sure that we can even reach that range with our gun as is, but I can change the gun in order to work with that. Minimum altitude to engage doesn't matter. Maximum altitude to engage doesn't matter. This would be really important to set if your gun specifically had been built so it wouldn't target air. Now, maximum speed to engage, that is the speed of the target. Again, this is the primary weapon, I don't care how fast it's moving, just shoot at it. It's a machine gun, it should be able to hit some things. Minimum number of blocks to engage. Now, that's new to me, that I imagine affects, like, don't fire on a 3-block raft or something, just aim at things that are a bit more substantial. But we're going to leave it as attack anything, and maximum fire rate... That's fine. Just unload all of your ammo stores on the first thing you see. I really don't mind. In fact, I welcome you to destroy everything utterly. However, now we need to add a wireless receiver, also some connectors. So I want the connector somewhere fairly well protected though. Let's have a look around. I mean, I guess I could put it over here. I will be replacing most of this place with extra protection as well, because I don't obviously want anything ruining my my engine. But if we place this like that, I can have a wireless receiver here. I don't think you need to make it face the AI. It's connected to the mainframe, fantastic. I also want a radar system about here. Now let's actually have a look at this. The radar will detect any constructible within line of sight and within radar range. It will not detect underwater. If I place that there, range 40. Can I turn that on? Can I make it larger range? If I place that there, has it got a longer range? No. Okay, so that's a range 40 radar system. Now these are allowing our AI to detect things. We've got a tracking laser. This unit will track an already detected target, use a detector or a radar to detect in the first place. Provides velocity information for a target, as such improves accuracy. Okay, let's get one of those built. That sounds useful to us. Now let's have a look at it. Range 500. It is connected to the mainframe. This is currently turned on. And occasionally you'll see a little ping coming out from the radar if I zoom out a little bit. There we are. Not sure if that's going to come through on YouTube so much. Finally, we will go for the detector 360 degrees. This unit will constantly rotate and search for targets using a laser. Once detected, they will be fired upon by the weapon controllers and engaged by naval and aerial AIs. Now, I can only imagine that line of sight is going to affect this. So I'm going to place that a little bit higher up. We'll see if it is affected. Yes, it's affected. So it can't see things lower down there. And well, that should just hopefully help. Now, of course, we want... I kind of want the tracker up there as well. How about I try to put the tracker laser above this one? Will it work? No. Tracking... Oh, no, it is connected to the mainframe. Oh, that's fantastic. Elevation. Can I change this at all? Can I turn it on? Elevation, step 4. Azimuth, step 2. Okay. Range 500, tracking nothing. I wonder if I can do that with this as well, then. I've never tried this before. Will that work? Yes, it does. Well, how about that? That's rather awesome. In that case, let me put the wireless receiver there. Like so, and now we're going to encase the bottom of this with metal. Metal blocks. We really, really, really need to make sure that this is not broken, because if this gets broken, we are utterly buggered. So, with that in mind, we are going to be replacing the majority of these blocks with actual metal beams. Bring that back there. Place that. I should have done this using the mirror tool. That was rather silly of me. I will do that in just a moment. And up here, there we go. Right, let's get the mirror tool down. There we are. And replace these. And add another layer there. And there as well. There we go. That should help out a lot. Let's get these replaced. Also, get that set up. Now, unfortunately, this is taxing our engine a lot more trying to keep all of this going. We want a door as well. There we go. And then go to glass blocks. As we increase the weight, obviously, the engine has to struggle harder to keep things going. And that is a bit of a shame. Get one there. Get one there. And get in some windows as well. I know, I'm just talking about defending it and I'm putting in windows. Leave me alone. I like it to look good as well as actually work. And if it's a question between working and looking good, well, you know my answer. Alas. Right. That should hold there. Let's get this up as well. Oops. Faffing around with the controls a little bit there. Right. Let's get these metal blocks. Oh, actually, no. A beam will work there, too. That's actually pretty good. Okay. The important part of this system is now fairly heavily defended. We can actually just replace that. We don't need it. Let's get some windows at the back there as well. I really do like the fill ability in this game. It is fantastic. It's such a necessary component to building large structures, I feel. And let's just go ahead and fill this in with metal. We don't want anything hitting this engine. And in addition to that, we actually want to protect this quite heavily as well. There we go. And just metal blocks around this. Right, I'm not going to put the metal blocks any higher than that, because obviously it'll affect the ability for our AI to detect something. But that should be good enough, I feel. Actually, I've just missed a window on the side here, it looks like. Really? Was it not filling in the windows? Oh, damn. I guess the fill command does not work on mirror. I've probably learned that lesson before and then forgotten it. Okay, so our engine is a bit better covered. We are down to 199 of 441 power. That isn't great. I would like to add more repair bots, though. Let's add one there. And one there. So that's repair bots for the front of this vehicle. I would like some more internally as well. How much crystal have we got? We're down to 600. That's not great. Let's get a bunch of repair bots along the side here in this little cavity between the ammo supply. This should allow us to repair quite a lot of damage. Oh, was I mirroring it still? Oh, damn it. Let me fix that. That was silly of me. Just lucky that I didn't do more damage, honestly. Right, there we are. On that note, I think it's probably worth us getting some more ammo barrels as well. So let's get those built up. There we go. Right, ammo does not... Oh, actually, no, the ammo storage is already full. I'm pretty impressed with that. Now, there's one more thing that I would like to build back here. And it's quite an important thing, as it happens, with regards to our crystal situation. Now, we can have fuel storage, we can have supply pumps that'll move resources between two ships. We've got resource gatherers, we've got oil drills. What we don't have is scrap and crystal. Because the resource gatherer will gather natural, well, it'll gather whatever resources are in the area. Crystal is very uncommon to find as a natural resource in a zone. But we can use a scrap smelter, which will burn natural resources and turn metal into scrap. So you'll consume your natural and your metal to get more scrap. Or the crystal growth farm, which will just grow more crystals. But the caveat with this one is, it can't grow crystals from nothing. You need a crystal there, and then it will slowly grow more and more crystals. The crystal farm grows your existing crystal reserves. It does not work unless you have some crystals to grow. It increases your stores of crystals at a slow but noticeable rate. Useful primarily when the crystal income is low, but you have a bit in reserve. That is definitely our situation right now. You start off with a farm section that is 3x3. You place one there. Now that has gone up there, and then you place the trays above. But you know what? Actually, how about instead of this, I stack my ammo barrels up instead. That way I give one more layer for the crystal growth tray. Now these are the trays that actually grow them. They will grow up to 20 crystals. If you have less than 20, you don't need any more than one. But we've got enough to run a lot of these trays. So let's actually build all the trays we can. There we go. Right, so this... Oh, I've staggered that a bit. Let me fix that. There we go. Is that right now? Yes. Right, so this will be growing our crystals for us. Now, we want to put some more ammo barrels back down. There we are. That should do. And that actually brings us up to the amount of ammo we had before as well, which is actually quite nice and neat. Right, I do want to improve the protection around this section, because a stray shot could get in there, and if it did, it would literally blow this whole thing up. So let's take some precautions with that, shall we? How about in here? Ah, I can't see anything. That's not particularly good. Let's lock the orientation, go up, and build across. There we are. Right, that adds a little bit more protection. Let's get some metal blocks over here and build an actual door, I feel. And that will be our little way into our ammo area. Go to miscellaneous, grab a door. Okay, I feel we are starting to get somewhere now. Okay, we've improved that system quite a lot. Next up is to improve the actual gun itself. Is this controlling the gun? Yes, it is. Good. Right. How far away is Doom? Doom is right bloody there. Okay. Be right back. Need to improve gun. Significantly. Improve gun now. Custom cannons. We want another motor-driven barrel. I am going to increase the range that this thing can fire on. One there. Now I just want recoil suppression barrels on the end there. This is now a fairly long-range weapon. I also want another six-way controller. Where are you? Let's have a look. There should be a controller. Up-down connector, front-back connector, six-way connector. That's what we want. Right, we want the mirror point. There we are. We want auto-loaders. One there and one there. We want a gauge increase on the bottom there. In fact, we want two at the back here. So this is now a much more powerful weapon. We want regular ammo boxes on the outside. There and there. We want armor piercing underneath. There and there. Okay, we're starting to get somewhere now. And finally, we want explosive warheads in the middle. So this now has a fair bit more oomph to it. Let's have a look at that. Explosive damage 70, armor piercing 4.7, reload time 0.37, kinetic damage 740. It has 2,400 shells in 12 boxes. The final thing we want to do is add a little bit of protection to the front. I don't want something just being able to shoot at this and blow it up. So how about I add some armor plating to the front of this gun. It is pretty much the only thing that's keeping us alive when things attack. So, you know, it deserves a bit of protection, I feel. And let's add some protection on the top there. I'm going to try not to go overboard with this, but it's very easy to go overboard. Downward slope is what we need next. Let's lock the orientation. And there we go. And over here as well. Oh, wait. If I blocked it... Oh, no. The predictor is actually on the next layer down, so it's fine. Lock the rotation. There we go. Right. I feel that is good enough. But what it isn't good enough is the floor around it. We need to try and fix that up before the enemy get here. That is the final thing that we need to fix. Right. Let's... Is that connected properly? I don't know. Have I got enough metal? I should do. I was looking at that. That was me being silly. It was trying to add to the cannon, but it could not. Because it should not. Right, let's... it should be connected at the back still. So, I'm safe to do this. No. Let's get some more metal blocks then. I don't really mind too much if... actually, no. I really do need to use the these instead. There we are. And... Oh, no. I think... Yes, we've got our enemies are here. That is a little bit sooner than I would have liked. So I will just do as much as I can to put this back together. Like so. Hopefully that'll be enough. Right. Out of weapon control mode... Is this controlling my weapons? Are they turning to fire on things? When weapons zero can aim at current targets. We are tracking. They are out of range. Well, that is crap. Oh, no, it sounds... Yes! My cannon is firing! Destroy cannon! I'm gonna stay in here where it's safe. Right, how far away are they? Okay, everything has now come within range. Okay. Right, well, it's time to go and have a look at how our cannon is doing. I can see lots of balloons floating off into the nether. It looks like it's done a decent job. Are they all air targets? Because if they are, then there's no point in me taking out my torpedoes boat. No, I think it's already brought down the air target. Fantastic work, cannon! All right. It's not quite in the water, but it's in the water enough. Right, we're going to go out and grab our boat. Good luck, everyone. Right, boat. Your time, your moment to shine is here. Let's close that. What? No! My boat! All you wanted to do was kill the enemies. Those swines, they blew up your ammo. It wasn't well defended, I guess. Well, shit. Okay, I'll hang around here and I'll try and repair you. I'll try and help with my repair tentacles. As much as I am able. Alright, let's have a quick look. Damn it, why do you always need to rain when I want to fight? It's most unfair. Lots of things. One thing is tracking our boat, but most things are trying to track our fortress. And it looks like we're firing so slowly now that we're firing armor-piercing explosive shells, generally. Yes. We're doing a fair chunk of damage, too. Keep firing. It's trying to target his gun, so the priority assignment is working. Ooh, maybe you're going for the AI, which would be equally good. Keep firing. Come on. I need more guns on this fortress, I really do. Right, well, he's close enough now. There we go, you've taken out his main gun. Well done. That armor is really helping, I feel. And the repair bots are repairing my boat, which is equally awesome. More damage is needed. Right, is this fixed? I think it is. Okay, the door is not fixed, however. Oh, yes, it is. Okay, fine. I'm going to need to turn off the tractor beam. Let me go. And go back into commander seat. Now back out. No, back to commander seat. There we are. Right, okay, we can control this now. Right, lock position. All right then. Go. And rotate around. No, that way. And fire on the enemy. Damn it, I've got one turn on, don't I? Ah, balls, I really should turn that off. Okay, launch. Please. Now. Okay, that worked, I think. I need to get out of the way, though. They've got enemies over yonder. I can see from their cannon trails. Fire! Yeah, that one turn thing, I'm probably going to have to remove that, I think. Go forth, my children. Destroy the enemy utterly. And again, have I got more? Have we got any more ammo? I do. I'm getting more ammo supplied by the main fortress as well. Oh, my lord, that was fantastic! Well done. Well done, my children. Fire again! No. Okay, well, we're actually really low on ammo. I need to get one of those ammo resupplies, honestly. Alright, let's zoom out a little bit. How's my fort doing? We've done a fair bit of damage to you, but I need other things to hit. Where are all of the enemies? We've got two there, one over there, which is interesting. Five in total, that's kind of crazy. Alright, let's rotate the ship around, I think. Let's pull this right around, come on. Back we go. And let's move this. There we are. Let's lock position on my camera. Okay, I could attack that, but I'd rather not hit my own ship, so I'm not going to. Right, fire! Okay, now this is actually quite fun, taking out a little ship and leaving my fortress to deal with other things. Alright, how much damage are we going to do this time? I hope a lot. I have slowed right down. Do I have any more power? Yes, I do. Good. I've done a fair chunk of damage here, though I am taking damage too. Don't worry! It is honorable to die in combat, little boat! Launch more torpedoes. Right, that one's gone. That one's properly dead, which is fantastic. We're not going to have to worry about it any further. We've got one torpedo tube loaded. Come on, we can do this. Was that an airship of some kind? No, I don't believe it was. And I think we've just taken out the other one. Maybe that one. Or this one just went down. I'm not sure. I can't quite tell. No, this one is still definitely up and running. Launch more torpedoes. Also, get away from that stupid gun it's got. Wow, you are really actually spazzing out. It's kind of keeping you alive right now, though. So, well done. More. Okay, well, fine. Attack, full speed, ramming speed. That's why I got these rounds on my ship. And bang. Yeah, that's right. Didn't expect that, did you? I've got big pointy bits on the front of my ship for a reason. I am completely wrecking you right now with my rams. The ramming is real right now. It's reverse, though, because I can't quite properly attack it. And launch torpedoes! Ha-ha! Point blank torpedoes to the face. The other one is missed, though. How did I miss? I've no idea. I feel ashamed. All right, let's get back in there if we can. Full speed. Now, come on. Go, go, go. Full speed, straight into the face. That is where he needs to have the full speed. And also the cannon. Hit the cannon. Destroy the cannon. I think we have ruined you. Well done. Let's get out. Am I stuck again? Really? Ah, my lord. All right, let's try and aim this up properly. And have we got any cannons? Yes, we do. All cannons, launch. Torpedoes. That should honestly be the end of you. And if it's not, I don't care. I'm going to go get someone else now. Did they all go through you? I'm not sure. I think all of my torpedoes went through the hole in his ship. It looks like my fortress has dealt with its problem. So it's joining the fight over here now, which is good. See if I can just split you in half. Cut you in twain, perhaps. No, I don't have enough power anymore. Oh, I'm just a little bit disappointed, I've got to be honest. Kind of wanted to break you. Oh, well. Let's go for you, then. You little scallywag. Oh, actually, no, I think he is actually gone. I've no longer... I should have been paying attention to the readout at the top. Not wasting my ammo all over the place. He's dead. I'm only fighting one enemy, and it's over here. It's out of range of my fortress, though, so that's fine. Launch! That's right. Go forth, my torpedo children. You are doing the gods' work. The gods will it, trust me. They told me. That... I kind of like the way they're wave riding at the moment. It must seem kind of intimidating. Well, if you weren't an AI, it would seem kind of intimidating. Just watching your doom slowly surfing its way toward you. And there we go. Should see some explosions. Yes. We've hit ammo, I believe. In fact, we killed him. One volley. Ah, that was good. Power is dropping pretty sharply, though. I believe we're running out. Where is our fortress? Our fortress is over yonder, towards the resource zone. No, no, power's coming back. I think maybe we took a couple of volleys to the engines, maybe, or propellers even. Yeah, we're getting... No, yeah, well, I can't tell. Our power is actually decreasing, not going up. Okay, we are running low. Batteries are depleted, I suppose. But that was a long engagement. We did okay, I think. And I'm pretty satisfied with the AI control on the fortress. I think more weapons are necessary before I can really leave that thing by itself, but we'll have to see. Power is really decreasing. I'm not sure we're going to get back in time. But if not, well, I can just add a couple more batteries. I think this little runabout has shown that it is a force to be reckoned with, honestly. Let's go in. Let's drive normally with the windows. That's why I put them there, after all. I like it. I'm steering the wheel and everything. Good times. But yeah, I think more power is absolutely needed because the power is dropping so quickly. And once this power is gone, I'm not going to be able to... Well, I'll be able to steer, but I won't be able to move forward, really. I'm so sorry. You almost made it back in time. I guess I could have the fortress come pick you up. I'm not sure. What's our speed? I'm not actually tracking that. Perhaps I should. Let me add that to the HUD. Options. HUD. Speed. Yeah, we'll just go with speed magnitude. Exit. Resume game. We're down to 3 meters a second, 2 meters a second, soon to be 1. Yep. Yeah, we've got one power. It's all we've got. And that's pretty much it. Well, damn. Okay. That's it, really. We're kind of rocking back and forth. Mostly the motion on the waves, really. Okay, well, I'll see if I can track you in. If not, you'll eventually drift close enough, or I'll come get you with the fortress. Just try not to stab the fortress with your spiky bits. I return! Your master is coming home! No, no, it's okay. Don't need to cry. Those oily robot tears, you'll make me cry as well. Very well done, though. I'm very proud of you, little fortress. Right, can you pull him in? On? Can we get him? Holy crap, what am I looking at? Ah, is that this vehicle? Stop, please. Exit. Oh-ho! We've got you back! Do not worry! You are safe and sound. Ah, oh, good times. The fortress is doing well for itself. At least against the Danger 30 enemies. Though my engine is struggling to recharge that ship now. Well done, Cannon. I feel that we owe this victory to you. Okay, well... Oh, maybe those torpedoes as well. I think that's a good point to wrap up this episode. Let's just check how the Deepwater Guard feeling at the moment. Are they feeling suitably depressed? I hope so. I think it's soon time for us to go over there. And, well, I think we need to work on our boat in the next episode. Make it ready to go and take on Danger 10 Fleet by itself. Let's check. Are you sending anything at me? No. How about you? No, you don't care. That's fine. I don't think you care either. However, there is a command to bring up diplomacy. There we go. Deepwater Guard. Relationship to you is aggressive expansion. -27.4, because I keep blowing up their ships. Well, you know, it's your own fault, really. Aggressive expansion with me. Most people are suspicious. Why? I'm wonderful. What? How can you possibly doubt me? But it looks like the Deepwater Guard are the only ones we need to worry about just yet. Are any of them particularly low? No. The Deepwater Guard allied to anyone? Well, they're friendly with... let's actually have a look. Who are you? The Twin Guard. Okay. We are probably driving down our attitude with the Twin Guard then a little bit. But honestly, most people actually dislike the Deepwater Guard quite a lot. So, we're probably okay with them. In fact, we're probably driving up our relationship with the White Flayers right now by being so aggressive towards the Deepwater Guard. Not even that we're being aggressive. Again, you know, it's like Harlech. Upon their soil, we never sought them. Or upon their waves, I guess. Or upon their ocean. No. It's all one big ocean. The ocean doesn't belong to anyone. How stupid. But that is it for this episode. We have drastically improved the defenses of the fort, though I need to make a better way of getting into the command center. But I think the final thing we're going to do in this episode is this. A fortress controller. I think it is time. There we go. We have a little wheel to control our fortress, and we're also going to have a little chair to sit in while controlling our fortress. It does look significantly more complex than the other controllers, I agree. Now the AI should be able to control the fortress, and in fact, if we wanted to, we could take our fortress with us over there. We're not going to do that, though. No, we are going to rely on the power of our little ship that we are going to build up in the next episode, specifically for the purpose of taking on a Danger 10 fleet. That should be an interesting fight, to say the least. But that is it from me. I do hope you've enjoyed this episode, and I hope you will be joining us in the next, where we will probably be doing more fighting. There'll probably be a lot of building to start with. We might actually spend the whole episode just preparing for the fight. But that is it. So, once again, I do hope you've enjoyed this episode, and until next we meet, do take care.